In this tutorial, we will be exploring the retouching tools in Photoshop using three different photographs. First, we're going to start with this photograph of a lighthouse, and I'm going to show you the patch healing tool. We are first going to remove this lighthouse, just get rid of it completely. We are also going to remove the clouds, some of these details in the photograph. This tool often works best if there is kind of a blank space next to it that's about the same size. So in this case, we have this nice sky and we do have some hill right here that we can replace this lighthouse with. So I'm going to select this tool for my toolbar. It's located over here. And I'm going to just trace around and make a complete circle around the lighthouse. And you want to close your selection so you can see the marching ants. This is now selected. When you hover over the lighthouse, you start to see a little arrow appear in the patch tool. What that arrow is indicating is that you should move your cursor to the right. So I'm going to click into the lighthouse and hold. I'm going to drag my cursor to the right. And you can see what it's doing. It is taking what is to the right and overlapping the lighthouse. I want to keep the ground kind of level, so you can see if I move it up and down, the ground disappears. So if you kind of keep it level and to the right, then that's gonna work best. Okay, I'm going to release my cursor and see what happened. I'm gonna deselect. Okay, the lighthouse is gone. This did an okay job. Let me zoom back in. See, we have kind of a halo effect, but up here in the sky, it did a really good job blending that sky, so it's completely seamless. What you can do next is go in here and just try it again, and just see if you can get a better result. There may be some other tools you have to pair this with to get this perfect. Okay, we're gonna try the same patch tool on some of the clouds. So I'm going to circle these clouds up in the sky, drag my cursor to the right. And again, this just did a great job filling in the sky and making a seamless removal of those clouds. And it actually copied this little patch right here. So, you know, you can do this as much as you want to get the result that you're looking for. There's some other details in this photograph you can remove with the patch tool. Let's move on to a different photograph. And this time we're going to use a different tool. We're going to try the spot healing brush. So I'm going to zoom in. We are going to remove some of these sprinkles with the spot healing brush. It essentially takes pixels from around an object and fills it in for you. You can also make your cursor larger with this tool up here. I'm essentially just going to take this spot healing brush tool and paint over some of these sprinkles. And you may have to hit the move tool or a different tool to actually see the result. So I'm just going around and covering up the sprinkles one by one. And you know, this is doing an okay job. I'm seeing some variation in my colors where the sprinkles were, so you can go back and just paint them again. But again, it's just kind of taking the colors that it sees around these sprinkles and filling it in. Another tool I'd like to show you, which is my favorite tool of all the retouching tools, is the clone stamp tool. This does kind of the same thing as the spot healing brush. It takes pixels from around an object and covers it up in this case. So let's go and remove a couple more sprinkles to show you how this tool works. Okay, so with clone stamp tool selected, I am going to essentially select some pixels from the right of this yellow sprinkle and copy them on top by clicking the option key, selecting this area right next to it, and then I'm going to drag my cursor over and cover it. And you can see a preview of it as you're doing it, which is cool. Okay, so let's do a few more. I'm going to option click and I'm just going to cover and paint this sprinkle. Option click, cover the sprinkle. You can also copy over pixels from a different part of your photograph into a different area. I'm going to option click this sprinkle right here, and I'm going to paint it over here. Option click a sprinkle here and paint it over here. Option click, paint. Now let's go over to a new photograph and let's try to retouch some skin. And let's use some of the tools we just went over. Let's go back to our spot healing brush tool. I'm going to duplicate my layer here, and I'll show you why in a few minutes. Especially when you're editing someone's face, you can often overdo it, and you might want to bring back in a few of those imperfections and details. Let's go back and paint over these imperfections. My tool's a little weird sometimes. I have to click off to actually see it work. Yours may work fine. Let's go back in. I'm just going to touch up a few more spots on her skin. At this point, I might have over-edited her face. If I wanted to maybe bring back in a few of those details, this top layer, you could change the opacity. So I could bring all of them back, or I could make this about 50%. So you can still see some of those imperfections, but they are just less noticeable. Okay, and if I were really editing this for a magazine or something, I would also want to get rid of all this hair up here, this wispy hair. And the clone stamp tool is my favorite tool to use in a situation like that. So to get rid of some of this hair, remember, we have to hit the option key and click. And we want to just hit the option key and click right outside of this hair. So we're getting the same color sky. So I'm just gonna paint. And hair can be a lot of work to cover up, so you can kind of do as much as you feel like is necessary. But you could get really detailed in here and get rid of all of it. And then last thing I would do is I would really go around her face and look. She has a lot of hairs kind of over her forehead. You might want to clean those up. Clone stamp tool is a really good tool to use for that. And then looking for other imperfections close up. Like I see some hair on her jacket as well. So you could clean that up. This might be a little more difficult to clean up with the clone stamp tool because of the pattern on the jacket, but you would just have to zoom way in and just select tiny little areas to cover that up. So that's how you retouch using Photoshop. Follow Cry Studio for more YouTube tutorials. Thanks so much.